The next truth, Patanjali says, prajna. Samadhi and prajna. Samadhi means constantly trying to be in the deep silence, the gap between the two thoughts in your inner space. See, the gap between the two thoughts of your being, you again and again experience samadhi every moment in your life. The problem is, you don't have patience for that gap. You are running, 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 without even knowing why you are running. I have a story for you. An overweight man went to the doctor who advised him to lose 10 pounds. The doctor recommended that the man should run 5 miles every day for the next 100 days. The patient phoned the doctor exactly 100 days later. Doctor asked, "Have you lost the weight?" Patient said, "I have, but I am not at all happy with the situation." Doctor asked, "Why?" This guy says, "Because I am 500 miles away from home." The fool is running, 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 not turning back. Sometime you are also just running, 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 not looking in the gap, not coming back. If you are continuously running, you might have achieved 500 mile goal, but you will not be in home. Same way, if you are continuously running behind your mind, you may achieve what you want in the outer world, but you will not be in the home. You will be far away from the home. So come back to the gap. Coming back to the gap is what Patanjali calls samadhi. Make time. Make time to come back to the gap. Don't say, "I am not able to." Every moment the gap is happening inside you. Because of the gap only the next thought is able to come. Understand? It's like the fish tank water bubbles coming. It may look that all the bubbles are interconnected, but they are not. There is a gap. Same way, you may feel the thoughts are continuously connected. No, there is a gap. Relaxing in that gap is what Patanjali calls samadhi. The fifth idea Patanjali is sharing is prajna, means discrimination. I can say, the pure consciousness which awakens discrimination, that's what is prajna. Because discrimination word is too poor word for prajna. It's too poor word for prajna. The big problem is the Sanskrit can never be translated as it is. I have to use many words only to give you the concept which is expressed through that sutra. Discrimination, please understand, consciousness which awakens the discrimination. When you are aware, when you are conscious, you can never make a mistake. You can never make a mistake. When you are conscious, constantly you respond to the situation in the present moment. See, if you are not conscious, you act based on your engrams, not based on the truth, your own intimate experience. If the prajna is there, you act based upon your own intimate personal experience. If the prajna is missing, you act based on the samskaras, hearsay, what they will say, what he will say, what the other will say, from the samskaras. the person who is operating from prajna will have a deep discrimination. He will have very deep discrimination. I have a story for you. Two gas company servicemen, one old, one young, were calling on houses in a neighborhood, checking the meters. At the final house on their round, a lady watched through the window as they checked the meter. Their truck was parked at the end of the street. Suddenly, these two guys thought of having a small game. They decided between them to prove their fitness. Who will reach the truck first? The older man challenged the youngster to a race. As they ran to the truck, they were surprised to find the women from the last house huffing and puffing right behind them. "What is wrong?" they asked that lady. She gasped and said, "When I saw two gas men running as hard as you can, I figured I would better run too." Sometime you are also running behind gas men, not knowing why they are running. When the prajna is not there, you run based on samskaras, fear, not based on the real experience. With prajna, with consciousness, you will be very clear what I mean by the word consciousness. Please understand, just when I started the discourse, what I said, just being inside your skin, just be inside your skin. Deal the persons, situations, places, everything directly, everything straight. Be inside your skin and deal the things directly, then you will be very clear. You will be very clear what you can, what you can't, what is your life, what is your goal, everything. You will be very clear. You will be very clear what you can and what you can't, what you want and what you don't want. There won't be any confusion. There won't be any confusion. You will be just straight. I have a story for you. A woman went with her husband for his routine medical checkup. But afterwards, the doctor took her to one side and said, "I am afraid I have some bad news. Unless you adhere to strict routine, your husband will die. Every morning, you must give him good healthy breakfast. You must cook him a nutritional meal at night. Furthermore, you must not burden him with household chores. And you must keep the house spotless and germ-free. I know it places a great deal of work on your shoulders, but it really is the only way to keep him alive." On their way home, the husband asked his wife what the doctor had said to her. "Oh," she replied, "he said you are going to die." You will be very clear what you can and what you can't, what you want and what you don't. With consciousness, there is no confusion. There is no confusion whether you can do or can't do. The dilemma between can and can't will not be there. The dilemma between want or don't will not be there. The power of consciousness, prajna, will remove ajna. Please, ajna means ignorance. Prajna means beyond ignorance. As long as you have ignorance, be very clear, you do not have prajna. Somebody goes to Buddha and asks, "Buddha, I have a huge problem in my country." He's a king. Almost all the kings who were alive in Buddha's period in India were either sannyasis of Buddha or disciples of Buddha.
like us.
He showed in his life, kingdom is nothing. Kingdom is nothing. He showed in his life, the kingdom is nothing. And the great truths of spirituality is the strength. Almost all the kings were his disciples. Either they have taken sannyas and left the kingdom. If they are sitting in the kingdom, they are ruling as Buddha's representative. That's all. Goes and asks, there is so much of confusion in my kingdom. Please give me some advice. How can I sort it out? Buddha says, sit and bring your awareness to your breathing. He says, if I am sitting like this, they will not only take away the kingdom, they will kill me and everything will disappear. Buddha says, just listen to what I am saying. And beautifully, the king expresses, he says, when I listened, I sat with myself consciously. Suddenly I could see the root of the problems. When you see the root of the problems, you have solution. Please understand, when you see the root of the problem, you have solution. The big problem is, sometimes we don't look into the problem and try to find out solution. We don't have patience to look into the problem but try to find out the solution. That is where the whole problem starts. If you can just look in, you will see not only you have a solution, suddenly problem dissolves. Problem dissolves. The problem itself do not have its root. The root in which it is rooted, the very root disappears. So as Patanjali says, Shraddha Virya Smriti Samadhi Prajna Purvaka Itare Sham. The highest samadhi is attained by people by faith in the path, energy directed in the path, repeatedly bringing to the awareness the path, centering yourself in the silence between the thoughts and discrimination. Please understand, these truths are straight, can bring results now. When I say bring yourself to samadhi, bring yourself to the gap between the thought, you don't need anything to do for that. Just sit now, look inside, just see your thoughts, you will start seeing the gap. Just relax. There is some song in Tamil, a traditional song, "Oh, very difficult, O Shiva, to be your devotee." When somebody sang that to Ramana Maharshi, he said, "No, oh, so easy, the enlightenment science." He says, "Very easy." And disciple asked, "How can it be easy?" Ramana Maharshi says, "If you want to achieve something which is in the outside, you need to work for it. But if you want to achieve something which is inside, just keep quiet." I tell you, the samadhi is neither difficult nor easy. It is. Even with the word easy, there is little bit of difficulty. Even that difficulty is not there. It is. It's instantly it can work on you. Just instantly it can work. Just now you can sit and see the gap between one thought and the other thought. One thought will raise, then another one thought will come. Another one thought will come. Just see the gap. Suddenly you will see, you will be able to see the gap for a longer period. The gaps will become more louder than the thoughts. Instantly you can experience. I am not saying start this for 12 years. After 12 years, when you have a long beard, the long hair, it may work. No. Instant, just now, It can happen now. Look inside and see the gap between one thought and the other thought. You'll see within few minutes the gap is becoming bigger and bigger, deeper and deeper, wider and wider. Just in few minutes, I have a story for you. A man died and went up to heaven. There he was greeted by Saint Peter. He asked, "Who are you?" This guy says, "My name is Stephen." "What did you do for a living?" "I was unemployed." "Unemployed? Have you ever done anything good in your life?" That guy said, "As a matter of fact, I have. I was walking along the street once when I saw a group of bikers who were threatening to beat up a defenseless girl. So I rushed to her rescue, pulled the ringleader off by his hair, kicked him hard where it hurts, and told him and his gang to clear off." Saint Peter said, "Oh, that's highly commendable." And he was flicking through that man's file. And he says, "But I can't see any report of that incident. When did it happen?" The guy replied, "Just 5 minutes ago." If you have missed the joke, ask the people who are laughing. Even if you miss the joke, don't miss the laughter. When you mess up with bikers, in 5 minutes, naturally you will be in heaven. Instant. You don't need to wait for years. Understand, when you sit and watch the gap between the thoughts, instant you will have samadhi, even before the incident gets recorded up there. Even before the file goes up there, you will be in here. Understand, this sutra of Patanjali is straight, can be experienced now.